Hello and welcome. My name is Lexi, and here I like to talk about luxury beauty. So a while back, I did a little mini series with there were three videos in there, all on the best lipsticks for the fall winter season. And broke them up into different categories based on the color story, and we had different finishes and so forth in there. And I had a lot of requests to go over lip glosses and liquid lipsticks as well. So that's what we're gonna look at today. So there are kind of, a few categories of, colors or finishes that I would highly recommend in a collection, but we've got a lot of options here. So we're actually going to be looking at 16 lip glosses and liquid lipsticks. I decided to combine them, together in one video, and we're going to start off with some arm swatches, then we'll move on to the lip swatches. So one of the finishes that I think everybody should have in their collection, and this is good all time of year, is some sort of, sorry, I dropped the lid, some sort of a clear sparkly gloss. And this is from Guerlain's holiday collection. This is going to be their rose gold gel gloss. And you can use this on the face as well, works well as a highlight and so forth. But look at this. It's pretty much a clear, translucent base. This one feels it's going to be a thin, lightweight gel. You can see you've got some sparkly, like pink and gold flecks in there. And this is something you can wear on its own, or you can layer on top of other products, and it just gives a little bit of shimmer. Now, another option here, this is one that I use all the time, and if you don't like a pot, this would be a good option. This is the Tom Ford Gloss Luxe Lipstick in 21 in the buff. You can see it looks pretty clear here, but you can see through the tube. You definitely have some shimmer. And look at that. So you can see again, we've got this is pretty much a translucent base. It's actually the very, very faintest hint of peach in there, but you have just a little bit of shimmer. This is actually very, very subtle on the lips. So we'll look at that in the lip swatches. And one thing to note between these two glosses, you can see they're going to look very, very similar. So you obviously don't need to have both. But we do have the Tom Ford with a slightly more pigment in the base. It's not going to be something noticeable on the lips. And then the glitter in the Tom Ford, it's also multicolor, but you're looking at a little bit more gold. And you can see that the Guerlain is actually a little bit more concentrated with the sparkle than the Tom Ford. The Tom Ford's going to be a little bit more subtle. Next, we have one of my favorite Chanel lip glosses. This is 722, and this is one of the shades that is in the holiday set from Chanel. Look at this. So let's just kind of break that out a little bit there. So this is going to be kind of a soft, dusty rose, like a nude rose shade there. And this one also has a little bit of shimmer. You can see here, this is going to be more, a little bit more of a silver shimmer, but it's very subtle. You can't actually tell the color of the shimmer on the lips. Moving on to another one of my favorite glosses for this would be a great everyday shade, and this is great all year round. This is one of the Hermes lip glosses in number 5, Rose Cola. I have to say, when I first saw the name, I really thought it said koala, but it's cola after the cola nut. And again, you can see this is going to be another one of those like nude pink kind of shades. It's similar to the Bourjoisie. Look how close they are. The Bourjoisie is a little bit deeper and it has just a little bit more brown in it. The Hermes has a little bit more rose. Next, this is for people who like cooler tones. This is the Ilia Balmy Gloss. They've got a lot of great colors, so if you like warmer colors, definitely check out a color like Saint. But this is Maybe Violet. And I feel like violet shades, lavender shades are really, kind of having a popular moment right now, but they are one of my favorites. This, is great if you're doing sort of like an icy, cool, wintry look or something like that. I use this one all the time. You can see it's gonna be a soft pink tone violet, and it's gonna add just a subtle touch of lavender to your lips. Next, I think it's always great to have a soft red gloss, especially, if you want a red lip, but you don't really want to commit fully to like a true red lip. A red gloss is great. This one here is going to be more nude. This is the Sisley number 9 in Sunset. And you can see this is almost, it's got a little bit more of a brick red mixed with some brown in there. So this is a really great everyday option. It's perfect for fall. And then we have another one here that's going to be fairly similar. This is 117 from Givenchy. This is actually a liquid lip balm. You can see that this one here is going to be just slightly more of a brick red, whereas the Sisley is a little bit more nude. It's also going to be more subtle on the lips. The Givenchy is more pigmented. And I think this particular formula is incredibly comfortable. Moving on, another, nod to berries. This is actually a pH-changing lipstick, but unlike many that turn bright pink, this will actually turn a berry. This is shade 011 from the Givenchy Liquid Lip Balms. And you can see it is more of a gray-black base that you see. And then as it comes in contact with your skin, it will change to a berry. So you can see it kind of changing color now, but we'll look back at this in a minute. And then this is actually my pick for, a holiday lip gloss if you're looking for a red shimmery lip gloss. This is Youthforia. They actually sent this to me, but I love this lip gloss. This is number 8, Make Some Noise. This is what I'm wearing today. And it's just a really great light red with some golden shimmer in there. And let me just get a little bit more there. Get a little bit bigger. So you can see it's going to be a pink tone red. So it's going to be very soft, easy to wear. I have it built up on my lips, but you can definitely get a lighter look with this. I just think it is such a great, kind of holiday shade or just a soft red in general. So those are my picks for lip gloss. And again, as for colors with lip gloss, I think it's really great to have some sort of nude everyday shade, a soft red, or even a soft red with some shimmer, and a clear shimmer shade. I think those are kind of, colors that, just are so versatile in a collection. And then obviously there are some other great shades if you love lip glosses, things like the deeper berries and so forth. Let's look at some liquid lipsticks. All right, next we're moving on to Clé de Peau. This is the Radiant Liquid Rouge Matte in 101 Cream Crush. This is a wonderful everyday matte nude. If you have been looking for, kind of that matte liquid lipstick or even just a matte lipstick that gives you that soft blurred look on the lips and it doesn't look like you have like a ton of makeup on, this is the shade for that. It's creamy and comfortable going on. It does give you that matte look. It adds a little bit of blurring and is very, very comfortable. You can see that this is going to be more of a peachy nude shade with a little bit of pink in there. So it's a really beautiful, great everyday shade. And I think this particular formula is really nice. Oh, I forgot one lip gloss. Let me go ahead and squeeze this one in. This is actually another soft red. This one doesn't really have the shimmer. It has a lot of radiance to it, but it's going to be an even softer pink red, if you're looking for something even lighter. This is the Clé de Peau lip gloss in number 8, Fire Ruby. And I love the Clé de Peau gloss wands, by the way, because the way that they are shaped, look at this. See how it twirls, it makes it really easy to not put on too much at one time and to really kind of, customize exactly how much product you want to put on there at once. It doesn't kind of glob on like some other lip gloss wands can do. So those are, I think, fantastic. Moving on to another matte liquid lipstick. These are the new Gucci mattes, and these came out this year. This one here is Cornelia Pink. I think this is a really great matte formula as well. I have to say, I think I prefer the Clé de Peau formula over the Gucci, but then the Gucci is probably next up. I mean, it's such a nice soft matte and comfortable. I think it's really great. So this is a really nice medium pink, just another everyday shade. And they have a ton of different shades, obviously, in the Gucci line, but I think that's a really great one to look at. Now, just a couple of Byredo liquid vinyl lipsticks. This one here is Vesuvio, and this is going to be kind of your orange shade. This is kind of like a burnt orange, more like a burnt pumpkin. It has a little bit more brown in it than a pumpkin, but this is going to be a nice orange. And I think this is a really great fall shade. If you are looking for something a little more holiday though, I love the Beze Cosmique shade. And this is the one from Byredo that has shimmer. So you have kind of this like burgundy, kind of like a burgundy pink with some gold shimmer in there. I think it's a great holiday shade. Now these two are liquid vinyls, so they're going to give you more of that wet look on the lips. But we have a couple of more liquid matte lipsticks. First up, this is Pat McGrath. This is one of the new matte metallics. This one here is Crimson Sunset. And if you're looking for some drama, I mean, this is gonna give that to you. Look at that. So you kind of have, this one's more burgundy than the Beze Cosmique, which you can see is more pink. So this is gonna be a little bit more of a, it has more depth into it. And it's, I mean, when I move my arm, can you see how you get a little bit of that gold glint from the metallic in there? This is really, really comfortable on the lips. I think this is a great formula. I have to say, I really love the Pat McGrath liquid matte lipsticks. Comfortable. They're very comfortable. They're very smooth, easy to apply. You know, I do think, you know, occasionally there's like some shades that are better than others, but I think that's true with all of the brands. And then last up, this is actually a Kilian liquid lipstick in number 320. These are highly fragranced, but if they weren't quite so fragranced, these may be like my favorite. If you're looking for like a impactful matte liquid lipstick, this is it. The formula is incredible on these. These are all gonna be, they're all like kind of bright reds for the most part. And yeah, I mean, it's just, this is something that will last. It lasts like all day. It's comfortable. It's going to give you that drama. It's a gorgeous shade. So I really love that. So those are the arm swatches. Let's go ahead. We'll talk a little bit about each of these while we go through the lip swatches. First up, we're looking at the Guerlain Gel Gloss in Rose Gold. Now, this is a limited edition item, so depending on when you're watching this, it may or may not still be available, but you get 4 grams of product, and it's made in Italy. It's a really nice, lightweight gel. More like a whipped Vaseline, but it doesn't have that petroleum jelly texture. It's just more of that thinness to it. So it's a really comfortable product. It's not going to be incredibly long wearing, but the colors in here are gorgeous. So you have that transparent base, you have this multicolor, you know, pink and gold glitter, but there's also the gold has a little bit of a greenish tint to it at when the light hits it a certain way as well. So I think it's a really beautiful product, and you can actually put on just a little bit to get a tiny hint of sparkle, or you can layer it on to get a little bit more. Either way though, it's never going to be, you know, like super sparkly, like metallic type sparkle. So it's just a really great product to wear on its own, or you can wear this on top of something else. And this is one that I usually, you know, I keep on hand because I really like adding this to different lip products throughout the day, especially if I don't want to change my lip color, but I just want to revive it a little bit. This is a great one for that. Likewise, we have the Tom Ford. This is their Gloss Luxe in 21 in the buff. And I have to say, I really do love the Tom Ford liquid glosses, but I feel like they discontinue my favorite colors all the time. This is one of the more recent ones. So I think this is a really great option to get a subtle sparkle to your lips. And that's usually what I use this for. I usually top this. I use this as a topper on something else. But we have 0.19 fluid ounces or 5.5 milliliters here. And this is actually made in Canada. So I think it's a really great lip gloss. You know, honestly, having something kind of sheer with a little bit of sparkle, you don't need to spend as much as a Tom Ford lip gloss. Honestly, when I bought it, I did not realize it was clear. So I love it and use it so much now because I have it. But if I had been looking just for a clear gloss with a little bit of shimmer, I probably would have just looked for something a little bit less expensive originally. So, you know, there are tons of products like that already on the market. Moving on, we have the Chanel lip gloss. This is the Rouge Coco Gloss in 722. one of my favorite shades. I have to say, I don't love the Chanel wands. You know, you can see how puffy they are, but I love this color. I've actually gone through a couple tubes of this. It's a go-to color for me all year. And you know, sometimes if I feel my lip color is just a little bit off, I will use this as a topper to just give it a little bit of a different color tone to it. But most of the time I will wear this on its own, and it just gives you kind of that soft, you know, nude pink kind of look to the lips, you know, and it's just, it's really gorgeous for an everyday shade. And I think the gloss formula on Chanel, it's not sticky. It is going to be a little bit thicker than some others, so it stays put a little bit longer than some others as well. So that is, you know, one of my favorites. I really like that. I feel like the Chanel glosses used to be incredibly popular, and they don't really get a lot of attention anymore, partly because Chanel doesn't really bring out new shades too frequently. But I think it's a really solid lip gloss formula in general. I really like those. And the Chanel gloss is 5.5 grams of product, and it is made in France. So moving on, we have the Hermes lip gloss. This is the Hermesistable lip glosses. And this one is number 5, Rose Cola. You can see you have a small flocked wand here. It's a petite glass packaging. I think these are really nice, and I really love these. So each of the Hermes lip glosses, they are going to be fragranced with whatever, you know, particular fruit is their namesake. So in this case, we're looking at the cola nut, and these, you know, they're very comfortable. This is made in France. We have 8.5 milliliters, and I think that these are going to be, they're a nice lightweight non-sticky gloss. They're going to last, you know, a couple hours on the lips. And this one in particular doesn't have any shimmer. It's just a great everyday shade. Next up, we have the Ilia Balmy Glosses, and this one here is Maybe Violet, and you can see, again, you've got your traditional lip gloss wand. I love the Ilia lip glosses, so I find these to be incredibly comfortable. They're actually technically a tinted lip oil, but they feel a little bit thicker than your traditional lip oil. I feel like usually a lip oil is going to feel a little bit thinner than this. This feels like a thin gloss. It's very comfortable. It's not sticky. This is made in Canada, and we have 4.3 milliliters in here. So it does come in plenty of other shades, but I love the Maybe Violet. It's one of my most used. Next, the Sicily lip glosses. These are the Lafito gloss. This is number 9, Sunset. There are quite a few wonderful shades from Sicily. It's a non-sticky gloss. Find it to be very comfortable. This was my favorite lip gloss for quite a while, and it's still right up there. If I had to pick just one as my all-time favorite gloss, not sure what it is right now, but I can tell you that this is still up at the top. And, you know, I find this one to be just a really great everyday shade for the fall winter time. It gives you a little bit of warmth, but, you know, it's definitely not going to be, you know, too bright or too pigmented. So it's really great for, you know, a daily basis. Now, these are going to be made in France, and we have 6.5 milliliters in these glosses. Next up, we have the Givenchy Liquid Lip Balms. I wanted to show you, this is the pH changing shade 011. After it has kind of reacted with my skin, you can see it's going to turn into a cooler tone berry shade, but it definitely has a little bit more purple in there than your typical pH changing products that are more pink. So we have 2 shades that we're looking at here. We have 117. This is going to be more of a brick red shade. And then 011, which is, again, the pH activated berry. And I have to say, I really love the formula on these. I find these to be really comfortable. They feel like a lip gloss, but when you're actually wearing these for a while, you really can tell that you're getting the benefits of a lip balm with these, or at least I can. So I find them to be just so comfortable to wear. They are fragranced like all Givenchy lip products, so just beware of that before purchasing. And these are made in France. There's 6 milliliters of product in each. We do have a glass, you know, tube with kind of like this vegan leather on the cap. And I find these to be just so incredibly comfortable and moisturizing on the lips. I love having them. And, you know, the marbled appearance, I think, is really attractive as well. So let's move on to our last two lip glosses. We have the Euphoria in number 8, Make Some Noise. And, you know, this is going to be, you know, if you're familiar with Euphoria, you know, they kind of have this like bright, it's like a tennis ball, a little green, a little yellow, you know, color in the packaging. This is going to be plastic. These, you know, it's just a nice lightweight gloss. And I love the shade. So you can see here that we have red and it has a little bit of silver shimmer in it. And I just think it is a really beautiful lip product here. And this is going to have a little bit more shimmer in it than some of the others that I shared with you, making this a really great, you know, holiday lip product. This is not sticky and it's kind of a medium weight lip gloss on the lips. And I find it really comfortable. I feel like texturally, it's fairly similar to the Sisley lip gloss and the Chanel lip gloss, kind of like that kind of weight and texture. Moving on to our last lip gloss, this is the Clé de Peau in number 8, Fire Ruby. So you can see this is actually going to be a plastic tube. We've got the Clé de Peau logo up here. And as I mentioned before, I think the wand on these is just really, really special. I love the Clé de Peau lip wands. I think they are the best on the market. So this product here, it's a really nice lightweight gloss. This might be my favorite lip gloss formula. You know, I hadn't tried it before the Sisley. It's actually been around longer than the Sisley formula. The Sisley was my favorite once I tried those for probably about 2 years. Now it's still up there, but I've tried the Clé de Peau lip glosses and they might just be a little bit better. So I really, really like these. And I just love this Fire Ruby shade for this time of year. But if you're looking for something everyday, all year round, shade number 3, Charm, that was actually recommended by a subscriber and is a true go-to shade for me. So I think that one's fantastic as well. Moving on to our liquid lipsticks, let's take a look at the Clé de Peau. This is the Radiant Matte Rouge or Liquid Rouge Matte in 101 Cream Crush. Again, we have kind of your traditional wand here. It's not going to be the same as the lip glosses. And, you know, the matte, this is actually glass, but we've got matte down here at the bottom to show you that this will be matte on the lips. They also have a shine version, which is going to be glossy on the container. And as I mentioned, this formula is just very, very comfortable on the lips. It's going to feel weightless on the lips. It's very thin and it goes on and just gives you kind of that blurred lip look. And you can see that you don't have to worry about getting precise edges with this. You could easily take your finger and kind of smoke out the edges around your lips and get that blurred lip effect as well. I just think it is such a gorgeous product. This particular shade in Cream Crush, such a great everyday shade all year round, but particularly during the fall and winter timeframe when you're going a little bit more nude and brown. I think this shade is just perfect for that. You don't want to look like you have a ton of, you know, lip products on or anything like that. This is a great shade for that. Now, the Clé de Peau liquid mattes are made in Japan. They have 8 milliliters of product. Moving on, we have the Gucci mattes, and I really think they did a great job with this formula. Now, they are fragranced, so that is something to know, and I wish they didn't have so much fragrance, but it's not that bad. It's not as fragrant as the Kilian, and honestly, it'll fade once you put it on. It's not something that lingers, so I think that's great. These are going to be, you know, this is going to be, compared to the Clé de Peau, that's a little bit more blurring. This is similar in texture and formula going onto the lips, but you can see that the actual formula itself on the lips, you have a little bit more presence of color. It doesn't really give you kind of that soft blurred effect. And by the way, I have other of the liquid mattes from Clé de Peau. That's kind of true of that formula, not just that Cream Crush shade. So this one here is just going to be, it's a little bit more sharp-edged, if that makes sense. So you'll see the edges a little bit more. You can definitely blur these out as well, but it's more like the pigmentation slightly stronger in the Gucci. And again, we're looking at shade Cornelia Pink. This is 6.5 milliliters and it's made in Italy. I think this is an absolutely fantastic formula. I would highly recommend those. Moving on to our liquid vinyl lipsticks. I really like the new Byredo liquid vinyls. I think they are great. One of the things though that really sways me on this formula over some other formulas is actually the color stories. I think this Vesuvio shade here, this orange, is just really perfect for, you know, if you want to have some warmer, more terracotta type shades. This is not a terracotta, it's more pumpkin. But if you want to have, you know, kind of those warmth in those shades, I think this is just a great shade for that. And the Baiser Cosmique, we looked at two shades. That one's the only one in this line that has shimmer. I just think it's such a great shade for the holiday. We have some gold shimmer in there. And these are going to be liquid vinyl lipsticks, so they're going to maintain kind of that glossy look, but they're going to stick around a lot better than a lip gloss. And they're also a lot more pigmented. They're more of a liquid lipstick. And you know, I think they're fantastic. So the shiny finish on those, after you wear them for a while, the shiny finish will kind of fade away a little bit, but you still have the color. It really sticks around. You can easily revive it with a lip gloss or adding a little bit more of this. But this is just, it's a really nice formula and they've got some great shades. So the Byredo liquid lips are made in Luxembourg and they have 4 milliliters of product. So moving on, we have the Pat McGrath liquid lipsticks. I have to say, I've tried some of her regular mattes. Those are great too. I think her formula on these is fantastic. But I love her new metallics, particularly for a little bit of drama when you're going to like a holiday party or something like that, or you just want something a little more unexpected on your lips. This Crimson Sunset shade is fantastic for that. You know, this is really just such a great, you know, holiday shade without being too holiday. A lot of times, you know, when you're looking at a holiday lipstick, everybody's going for the bright reds, and I love those. But sometimes you want red, but you want a little bit more depth in there, and you don't want it to scream holiday, but you still want to be reminiscent of that. And I feel like that's what this liquid lipstick does so well. It is a matte metallic. It stays put really well through meals and so forth. We have 5 milliliters of product. It's made in Italy. It's smooth. It's easy to apply. I just think it's fantastic. And I love this shade for this time of year. And last up, we have the Kilian liquid lipsticks, which again, I think the formula on these is incredible. And they would definitely be up there in my favorites for the matte liquid lipsticks if they weren't quite so heavily fragranced. But it's such an incredible formula that I couldn't not include it. And this will give you more of that brighter red lip. Now, Kilian liquid lipsticks, you know, they recently came out with some shiny ones. I have not tried those. But the matte ones here, they're all going to be shades of red. Even the shade, there's a shade that's like more nude looking in the swatches. It's still really more red. I have it. I have a video on those from when these came out last year. But I think they do the reds so well. And this one in particular is my favorite for, you know, holidays or just a little bit of drama. And this is going to give you more of that brighter Christmas red lip if that's what you're looking for. But it's just so great any time of the year that you're looking for a nice red lip. And when you're going for like an all out there red, I really think a matte formula is best because you don't have to worry so much about it moving around, getting on your teeth after initial application and so forth. So this particular formula from Kilian, it really stays put. It lasts really well. It's going to kind of stay on your lips all day. You want to try and take it off, you're not removing all of that color. You know, this is really one that stays put. It's not truly mask proof. If you get it wet, you might still see a little bit of, you know, lipstick that gets on your mask. But for the most part, it's pretty mask resistant. And so I think it's a really great lipstick option. And again, they've got some great shades, but this one here, 320, is my favorite. And one more thing, in the other videos in the original series, I always do kind of like a top three of my favorites. So I figure we'll just go through my top three favorites for these lip glosses, as well as three for the liquid lipsticks. So I kind of chose three that, you know, I just think are kind of embody the spectrum that I think it's important to have. So we've got the Euphoria in Make Some Noise, which is on my lips. We have the Givenchy in number 11. This is the color changing one. And we have the everyday gloss for me, the Ilia Balmy Gloss in Maybe Violet. So those are kind of my top three, not in any particular order. And then for the liquid lipsticks, they actually all ended up being some of the matte choices, but I love the Clé de Peau in Cream Crush for everyday. It's just such a great everyday shade. The Pat McGrath in Crimson Sunset for some drama. And then, I mean, I cannot resist the way this Kilian lipstick looks in 320. So those are my top three of, you know, both sets. And I would love to know your thoughts. So I hope this was helpful and you enjoyed my selection. But as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, I do think there are just a few kind of key finishes to have in your collection. As I mentioned with the glosses, that's kind of going to be your clear sparkly gloss to use as a topper, maybe like an everyday nude or nude pink kind of gloss, you know, to just have in your bag, and a soft red for when you want a little bit of color, but you don't want to go, you know, quite as bold as you would with a lipstick. Now, with the liquid lipsticks, I think it's great to have something like a vinyl where you can get kind of that glossy look, but you don't have to worry about touch up so much because it's going to stay put better than a gloss. And I think, you know, having a red matte liquid lip is key for anybody, because if you are, well, if you wear reds, but it's going to stay put better than a traditional red lipstick. You know, typically the longevity is a little bit better. It's very smooth. It can be a little bit harder to apply than a lipstick. You might need to, you know, dig out a lip brush and really, you know, be a little careful with those edges depending on your formula. Some of them are runnier than others. But the finished look is just absolute perfection, in my opinion. So I think that's definitely a formula that everybody should have in their collection if you wear reds. I know not everybody does. And then I also think it is great to have some sort of soft liquid matte blurred look kind of lipstick that you can put on, and you can top with gloss if you want, or you don't have to, but it's just like an everyday kind of base kind of color. And those would be my recommendations. I think those are really, you know, just great products to look for, whether you go for colors that I chose or not. But you know, those are, you know, great finishes to have in your makeup collection. So thank you so much for tuning in. I'd love to know your thoughts, what your choices are, and if you have any of the ones that I use, what your thoughts are on those. So please let me know. Also, let me know if you're interested in seeing more videos like this in the future. Thank you so much for tuning in. I sincerely hope this was helpful, and thank you so much for all of your support this year. I really appreciate it. If you're new here, please hit that like button. It really helps more than you might think. And, you know, share and subscribe. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I will see you very soon. Have a wonderful day.